Good evening, everyone. In self-help group, basically, when we ask questions, so we find that people have one is level of knowledge. They are not trying to go to the second level of knowledge. So by this topic also, we will try to introduce you to second level of knowledge. Second level of knowledge is that since we started this in our country, 1992 onwards, so you can take 1992 onwards to now as 25 years, isn't it? And in 25 years, lots of developments have happened regarding self-help groups, isn't it? So when lots of developments have happened regarding self-help groups, so if you write merely the problems, let's say that, problems they face, this problem, that problem, don't you think that you will have to have some new facts and information? So if you are writing those facts, information, etc., which may be 5 years old, 7 year old, and the answer will be more relevant 5 year old, 7 year old, not today. Right. Means we are not at formation stage of self-help groups. We have gone, let's say that, from that stage to institutionalization stage. So when we started during 90s, so we were in the formation stage of self-help groups. And therefore endeavor was that more and more self-help groups should be formed, constituted, supported. But when there are 25 years, so don't you think that some self-help groups have become very successful? They have their expansion, they have got institutionalized, and when they have got expansion, institutionalized, they have become very big. So they will not have the same problem as self-help groups face at formation stage. Their problems will be different. Right. This is how the two generations, so second generation is beginning, this is how you should know that. That is how second level of knowledge. Through that also you will try to know it. Anyhow, self-help groups are informal groups, informal sector also, which promote basically inclusive development through financial inclusion, self-help efforts. We started in 1992 through NABARD program, right, in Mysore, a pilot project which was known as MIDA. So this is how, let's say that we initiated. Once this pilot project was successful in Mysore, Karnataka, then it was, let's say that, expanded throughout the country since 1995. And it was a project by both RBI and NABARD. And since then, NABARD has a bank link self-help group program. So NABARD has a bank linked self-help group program under which it has provided more than 1 lakh crore credit. Right. Not 1,000 crore, 2,000 crore. It has provided 1 lakh crore credit to self-help groups. We have more than 8 million self-help groups in our country, which is highest in the world. Therefore, self-help group is the largest informal sector women empowerment program in the world, in our country. Right. So these are some basic facts. Right. Let's come to our point. Kudumbashree, you know. Right. You should know that there are some self-help groups which are very big. One is called Kudumbashree, another is called Seva, another is called Rijat Papad. Right. And the state you belong, certainly there will be some self-help group of your state is specific. Seva has more than 1 lakh members. Kudumbashree has more than 2.5 lakh members. Means Kudumbashree has 2,77,000 something. Right, members. Kudumbashri was established in 1997. Kudumbashri basically aims for eradication of poverty. Eradication of poverty from state. Kudumbashri in Malayalam is known as prosperity of family, something like this. Great. Kudumbashri has partnered with local government of Kerala. And it works with the local government. Means entire state. It has not partnered with one district, two districts. No. It has partnered with the state itself, with the local government. So you can imagine, right, the level of efforts. Then Kudumbashri became in news because of flood in Kerala. Right. That's why we are discussing here, otherwise we may not have discussed. So when flood in Kerala came, so this is how they provided all sort of helps. Right. They have given few crore to the state fund. Imagine. A self-help group is contributing to a state relief fund. Rather, a self-help group needs credit. Right. And I think it is right. So you can imagine this. This is called benefit of social capital. Right. It is not social capital. Benefit of social capital. Now Kudumbashri has given rise to a very strong social capital in the state. It is people's power. We keep saying to you, basically in case studies, write about people's power, solving problem by people. You keep writing by Aadhaar and etc. Right. You can imagine what people can do. What a people organization can do. Right. And if you see their level of service in Kerala flood, thousands of people they have held. Right. They have cleaned many such areas where people can live safe, etc. Right. That community service cannot be done by any such organization. Right. This is called social capital. Social capital means a society has different groups, community. And those groups and communities have trustworthy relationships. This is the definition of social capital. Right. And there is a report by either Niti Aayog or I guess ki NABARD that ki social capital means self-help groups in Kerala have become catalyst of social capital. This is the title of the report. Right. Catalyst of social capital. Means, what is, people have trust in social, this social capital, self-help group. Today, if anyone which is most trustworthy institution group is called self-help group. More than civil society. Then, this is how. More than civil society, self-help group is a highly trustworthy group, right, which is relied by government, society, etc. sectors. So these are some important aspects. They have been working with the state government in all sort of different areas. They have not helped in only, let's say, flood. They are helping in solid waste management. So when you deal question related to solid waste management, by the way, a case study is expected on that aspect also. Environment ecology related case study, especially on solid waste management. This is how self-help group you should not write, but community effort necessarily you should write. They are also working in urban areas on solid waste management with urban local bodies. Second, they are also promoting village enterprise. Social enterprises, they are promoting. Micro enterprises they are promoting. They are also helping to the farmers. So they are not all, let's say that they are created to help themselves. A self-help group is created to help themselves, but they are helping after success. Right. So once it becomes successful, it starts helping others. Right, so farmers, let's say women, children, or let's say solid waste management, or let's say the micro enterprise, etc. These areas, the facts are given, you can read it, ki how they are working in all different sectors. And this is how they have become, they are playing a multifarious role. Right, they are playing a multifarious role, and these community efforts are very essential and they are needed for local level development. Government has also recognized through different policy programs. It can be, let's say, National Livelihood Mission, right, or some other such programs, they are recognized. Right, but they are facing challenges. And their challenges are now the problems of second generation self-help groups. Right, so you can take from those problems also second generation, what will the problem? Now it has become big. So how to run the institution efficiently is a challenge. Right, because it is a big institution now. It has 2 lakh members, more than 2 lakh members. A company may not have 2 lakh members. Right, so power struggle within, power struggle outside. Right, now when an organization has become of 2 lakh, should we run like a self-help, or should we run like a business, or should we run like a state? Right, that is how. This is a new emerging problem. It's like temples are also managed by government. When temples have expanded, although they enjoy religious freedom, and if you will run like management or run like states, so voluntariness is lost. And the main motive to be created is voluntariness, self-help. The self-help is act of voluntariness, voluntary efforts. And once a state, means you run like a state or you run like a business, the main basis on which they have been created is lost. So should you continue with self-help group or you should go to? This is a challenge. How you will address this? Second is, right, their conflict with politics. You know that now self-help group has 2 lakh members and they can influence certain lakh members. So the political party which will exercise control on self-help group will also have benefit in, right, they are subject to political rivalries. Right, this, then there is a conflict with local government and self-help group. Right, this is happening. Then another is multifarious happening, so also you will have overburden. You are becoming overburdened. Right, because many functions you want to perform. Basically, you are for one thing. Promote spendthrift. The term is used. Promote spendthrift through self-help. Spendthrift means promote surplus, economic surplus, through economic cooperation. So this was their main basis for creation. They will either financially contribute themselves, which they will utilize for income generating venture, or let's say that state will support, or somebody else will also support through credit. And then they will generate, invest, work for income generating ventures through which they will earn surplus. Now when you perform multifunctions, so then your voluntariness is also lost. And you have pressure also on members. So voluntariness is lost. This is also, it is happening. This is another important issue. Right. And another important issue is this outside Kudumbashri is marketing challenges, which is not written in this, it is great. Kudumbashri is facing all these problems except marketing problem. It means even the model which is very successful is also facing challenges. Great. That's why it is the duty of the state to ensure that they remain largely apolitical. Politics should not enter, otherwise it will vitiate. That is the reason that North India, they are not very successful, right? Largely in Southern India. So it should be the duty of the state to protect self-help groups, because you can see the benefit of a social capital, the service rendered by the social capital. Therefore, it should be allowed to function without indulging too much in politics. So this is what you should write and mention. The relevance of this Kudumbashi is you can refer in any question, etc. That is how it is. Now I mentioned, let's say that a general problem. Through this also I want to teach certain aspect of self-help groups, not in totality, but some information. Self-help groups are also facing marketing challenges. What are marketing challenges? You should know that. Self-help groups, they have expanded. When they have expanded, traditionally they, let's say that they sold their product in local area. So they absorbed the local area. Once now they have absorbed the local area, to expand it, they will have to go to other areas. That will demand transportation cost. That will demand marketing of the product. And when you will go for marketing, transportation cost, the cost of the product will increase. And cost of the product increases, it will not be competitive. And if you will not expand, you become stagnant. Right. This is one. So basically they are facing marketing challenge. Second, in the era of all these, let's say mechanization, other such things, basically they have the small product, let's say handmade products largely they may have, non-mechanized products they may have. But there is also a challenge for mechanized, especially from Chinese goods, etc. Right. China can make in mechanized way, right, products which will have a better look than your handicraft. Right. This is how they have mastered. It will appear like it is a handmade product. But if you have a very close look, so you will find it is not a machine made. But they make it in such a fashion that from a distance it looks like handmade. Right. But we will not go in detail all these things, but this is how. Now, again, if you address their market challenges, it will compromise their voluntariness. Because what they will do is that they will focus on internal efficiency. If product is facing outside competition, then you will try that internally you have to be more efficient. And when internally you have to be more efficient, so you will go for skill efficiency. And you go for skill efficiency, you will hire people on the basis of skill efficiency. Then self-help will lost. Right. So whether we should link with MSMEs, it should be very sensitive. Because MSMEs, they are different, and self-help groups are different. So self-help groups cannot be considered as MSME. Right. This is the distinction. Although you can link it, but you cannot equate it. In recent times also, let's say that government is trying to link self-help groups with MSMEs. Right. Online can provide solution to their marketing challenges. Right. But Muhammad Yunus has given a concept of social enterprise. Right. They should be run like social enterprise. So we expect after few years this question, social enterprise. Although last year we asked this question, at times we regret why we asked. Anyhow, social enterprise, last year some articles were written on social enterprise in Mint, etc. Live Mint. Social enterprise is a non-profit sector run democratically, the way self-help groups are run. Right. Anyhow, so this is how, let's say, through Kudumbashree you can take. But towards the end I will tell you that there is no any initiative in our country, any scheme, program, anything which has given as much empowerment to women as self-help groups. It is instrumental. Second, it brings social, economic, psychological, political skill empowerment to women. So there is no any such scheme and program which is such type of empowerment. Because when women function, because 90% self-help groups are women groups. Right. And most of them are in southern India. Second, what we are trying to say that when women work as a group, they get socially and psychologically empowered. It becomes a platform. Right. Social psychological empowerment is important for read dignity and respect. This is our